Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ستمبر اکتوبر کے مہینے
says that the month of September and October, they are generally such months in which in most of the countries the annual gatherings of the auxiliary organizations take place. Today as well, inshallah, the Ijtima is going to start. Next Friday, Ansar and Lajna Ijtima will take place, inshallah.
تقریباً 27-28 سال سے
فار دی لاسٹ 27-28 اجتماعات
خلیفہ وقت کی شمولیت
اجتماعات
کا حصہ بن چکی ہے
دس ہیز بیکم اے کسٹمری دیٹ دی پارٹیسپیشن آف دی ٹائم
پاکستان سے خلیفہ وقت کی ہجرت سے پہلے
بیفور دی مائگریشن آف دی خلافت فرام پاکستان ان آل دی اجتماعات آف دی آگزیلری آرگنائزیشن دی اٹینڈنس آف دی خلیفت المسیح یوز ٹو بی دیئر اینڈ
سے تمام متعلقہ
اینڈ فرام پاکستان دی ریپرزینٹیوز آف آل دی آگزیلری آرگنائزیشنز دے یوز ٹو اٹینڈ دوز گیدرنگز
جس سے
اینڈ تھرو دس دی پاپولیشن اینڈ دی حسل اینڈ بسل آف ربا وڈ انکریز and especially the Atfal and Khuddam in those days with a very special zeal they used to come and they used to wait for these gatherings to take place they used to live in tents and every majlis they used to bring their own sheets and prepare their own tents and in a proper way the properly made tents which are available nowadays they were not available but rather with the bed sheets they used to make their tents and they used to live in those tents every majlis or every group living in that particular tent they used to bring their sheets and in this way multicolor and very you know printed different colors these tents should be were seen there In the month of October, the weather in Pakistan generally is good and there is no rain and it's quite possible to do like that. And perhaps here, because of the weather, it is impossible to go for those type of tents. But anyway, the UK Ijtima, the Khuddam Ahmadiyya UK, has brought to my memories the good memories of Atfal and Khuddam Ijtima in Pakistan and also it has brought the memories of those oppressed people, those who have been victim of these aggression of the opponents and oppressors, those who have been deprived from this right of holding these gatherings, and which was so good for their self-reformation and their reformation, and also they used to gather for the remembrance of Allah and His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They used to hold this ijtima for this purpose, but now they can't. But anyway, me and yourself, we are very firmly rooted in this belief that these conditions are not forever, inshallah. One day, this injustice and these people who are committing these injustices, they would be completely eliminated from the surface of the earth. Allah Almighty enable us to make full use of perseverance and steadfastness and prayer, and continue to bless us with that. And these things I should have mentioned on the occasion of ijtima.
But,
and every year I always address the members of the auxiliary organization with reference to these ijtimaat. But today I thought that in Juma I should mention these things because in Pakistan, in the central ijtima of Khuddam, the opening and the closing addresses were by the Khalifa of the time, and secondly, on the occasion of ijtima, these closing address, which is generally given there, that is not televised live on MTA. Rather, after a few days, after 1 week or 10 days, it is televised later. And maybe that a large number of people may not be able to listen to that one. And thirdly, wherever the ijtimaats are taking place, such gatherings, they can take this khutbah as a message for them, and they can act upon these things which I am going to mention, and the oppressed Ahmadis of Pakistan should be remembered in prayers by all of them. And fourthly, wherever the new jamaats and the new auxiliary organizations are being established, they should also realize their responsibilities, and by listening to direct in the word of advice, they should also try to benefit from that. But anyway, now with this reference, I particularly to Khuddamul Ahmadiyya and all members of the Jamaat in general, I would like to say some points I would like to draw their attention to those. In the Holy Quran, the service to religion and reformation and the for the establishment of unity of Allah Almighty with reference to the youth, in Surah Kahf, there are two mentions we find there. They were such people, young people, who were the followers of Messiah, of Moses, who was for nearly 300 years, they suffered through the hardships and persecution. And they were so much tortured and so much persecuted that for a long time they had to hide in caves. And in caves, the government workers, they used to chase them and to kill them, try to kill them. But for the sake of religion and for the unity, they underwent all this persecution. When the condition would improve, they would come out. But when the condition of the oppression was such that they had to go through them from time to time. Anyway, for the establishment of Tawheed and for the safety of religion, the efforts of these people was worthy enough that Allah Almighty has preserved this incident in the Holy Quran. With this reference, the two verses which I would like to present, I am going to mention those. Allah Almighty says in the Holy Quran, إِذْ أَوَى الْفِتْيَةُ إِلَى الْكَهْفِ فَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا آتِنَا مِن لَّدُنكَ رَحْمَةً وَهَيِّئْ لَنَا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا رَشَدًا. That when some youth people, they took refuge in the cave, that they said, O Allah, you grant us mercy from yourself and provide for us right guidance in our affairs. And after two verses, they also, it is mentioned there, that nahnu nakussu alayka nabahum bilhaq innahum fityatun amanu bi rabbihim wa zidnahum huda, that we will relate to thee their story, we relate to you their story with truth. They were young men who believed in their Lord, and we increased them in guidance. So there is the next verse which explains that وَرَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ إِسْقَامُوا فَقَالُوا رَبُّنَا رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَنْ نَدْوَ مِنْ دُونِهِ إِلَٰهًا إِلَٰهًا لَقَدْ قُلْنَا إِذًا شَتَتَا. And that means that we strengthen their hearts when they stood up and said, our Lord is the Lord of the heavens and the earth. Never we shall call upon any God besides Him. If we did so, we should have indeed uttered an enormity, something wrong. So therefore, for the establishment of unity, they worked hard and suffered the persecution, and they continued to pray to God Almighty, that Allah the Almighty, out of His mercy and grace, establish them in the unity of Allah and continue to enable them to continue following the path of unity. Before that, the verses which are before that in the Holy Quran, in which it is mentioned there that the present day Christians, they are taking Jesus as Rather, Huzur says it was the teaching of unity. And Allah Almighty, after describing their condition, Allah Almighty has mentioned that their belief and believing in one God, because of that we established them in the true guidance and we strengthened their hearts, and they continued to announce the unity of Allah and worship Him. From this thing, and they firmly declared this one, that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. But then later on, under the influence of the time and the persecution, the Christianity, gradually they had the concept of Trinity. There was corruption in that, and the wrong people took hold of Christianity, and they became at the helm of affair, and the result of that was that what happened. And the worldly considerations, they occupied the whole thing, dominated the whole thing. And for these people who set up partners with Allah Almighty, Allah Almighty has warned that they are going to be the people of fire. So the purpose of mentioning these verses is that Christianity, whenever, as long as it maintained its original condition, the people who safeguarded that, they were the youth, and they protected their faith, and Allah Almighty, because of their faith, and in front of their very unjust oppressors, Allah Almighty, because they believed in Allah Almighty, the only one worthy to be worshipped, Allah Almighty kept them on the right path of guidance, the true guidance. And these people, they did not care for any worldly rewards. Rather, they preferred the pleasure of Allah Almighty. And Allah Almighty says that these few youngsters, along with them, with them, how did we treat them? Because of their faith. Allah Almighty says, وَزِدْنَاهُمْ خُدَىٰ. We increase them in their faith. وَرَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ. And we strengthen their hearts. And this increase in faith and this strengthening of the heart, and because of that, they, all the tyrants, rulers of their time, in front of them they announced, لَنَّدُوَ مِن دُونِهِ إِلَهًا, that we will never take anybody worthy of worship except Allah Almighty. We can lay down our life. We can go away from our rights. And we can offer the sacrifice of our beloved ones and our wealth. But we cannot desist from unity. So this is the example which is in front of us, of those people who believed, in front of whom there was no example of the role model which Allah Almighty has presented before us in the person of our beloved Prophet, the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and his companion. So in front of us, the best example of this specimen of this example has been presented. And in order to protect the religion, we have made a commitment that we should always be keeping this promise of that we have made of offering their life, property, honor, and everything. And no worldly temptation, no worldly gain will ever stop us from fulfilling and maintaining our promise that we have made to Allah Almighty. And the examples of the spiritual communities going through these persecution, when these things are mentioned, then the attention immediately goes to the example of the Pakistani Ahmadis, and also some other other countries are there, where the Ahmadis are being subjected to difficult times and torture. Today the Ahmadis in Pakistan, mentally and physically, they are going through the torture period of torture. But they are offering their sacrifices of the life and the wealth. And similarly, in Arab countries, the Ahmadis are there. The number of them, by the grace of Allah, it is increasing day by day. By the grace of Allah, in every day, I receive letters of the bath from Arab countries. In these Arab countries, because of their being Ahmadi, they are facing difficulties. And these Ahmadis are also living the life of the people of the cave, Sahabe Kahf. In Pakistan, there is an old Jamaat, and they definitely show the firmness of their faith. And the Ahmadiyyat of any Ahmadi is no more a hidden thing. But those who are newly joining the community, for them to declare their faith, it is becoming increasingly difficult. Majority of them, of those newcomers, they are very dedicated, and they are the people who are increasing in their faith. But there are some people who are weak, and for the strength of the community, it is sometime necessary that in a large number they should not be assembling in one place for meeting or for prayer or for Jummah. They are stopped not to go there. Some administrative instructions are to be given for the safety of Ahmadis. So these people, sometimes they become restless from Arab countries. They write to me that how long we are going to live like that. I always give them the example of the people of the cave, and I advise them to be patient. These days are going to change, and the history of the Prophet tells us that they do change, and they are going to change definitely. So the Ahmadi Muslims in those countries who get worried because of the situation, that they say that how long we are going to have their functions in hiding. As I said, they have to offer their prayer and Jummah in hiding. So I tell them that you have not yet tasted that player which was there under the canopy of Ijtimaat, which the Ahmadis had under the canopy of Khilafat. But despite that, for the last 28 years, these people are protecting their covenants and promises, and they are offering their sacrifices. because these are the servants of the Messiah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they are offering their sacrifices. This restriction for such a long time and the continuous torture is not an ordinary thing, is not a petty thing. But this these embodiments of perseverance and steadfastness, the young and old, and they are continuously offering this sacrifice. But these sacrifices are not going to be forever. These are not which are going to last more than 300 years. These are the sacrifices by the grace of Allah. Very rapidly, very quickly, they are taking us towards bringing us closer and closer to our victories and successes. In order to the effort to for the cause of the establishment of the Jamaat, it will not stop by the persecution of Ahmadis in some countries. The Ahmadis, the Jamaat Ahmadiyya has been allocated the responsibility that the message of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Islam to convey it to the ends of the earth and to establish the unity of Allah. These persecutions and oppressions and restrictions, this job cannot be finished. Jamaat Ahmadiyya, every day, by the grace of Allah, with a new glory, with a renewed glory, they are making progress. Recently, the foundation stone of the mosque which I laid in Ireland, this country in Europe, is also the citadel of Christianity. That in this respect, that people are more closely and dedicatedly attached to Christianity. They are mostly Catholic, and they're coming to the church, and attachment with the church is very strong there. Whenever the Christians and the most of the European countries, they have lost their connection with faith. But this country, which is also a end of the earth in a way, as I have mentioned in detail in my last sermon, here the foundation stone of the mosque and the reception in the hotel, in which nearly 100 people, well educated, including members of parliament and government officials and professors and teachers and people related with to various departments, they all attended. In the mayor of Galway was also there, and the priests and other religious leaders were there, and in front of all of them the message of Islam was explained, and the message of the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam was I was able to present. It was given a good coverage by the national TV and the press, and as a result of that, the beautiful teaching of Islam, it actually reached hundreds of thousands of people. So on one side, the attempt is being made to suppress the message of Ahmadiyyat, and on the other side, Allah Almighty is opening up new and new ways of tabligh for us. In Ireland, so far as the number goes, it's a small community. Majority of them, they are youth. By the grace of Allah, they are quite active Jamaat. But because of their being active, their links are also very good. And now, after this function, their contacts and tabligh efforts will inshallah further expand, and new ways will be found by them inshallah. If they continued with this zeal and the wide acquaintance which has been established, if they benefited from that, so I hope that these two servants of few servants of the Masih Muhammadi, they would be able to bring these people who have gone away from the unity of Allah and bring them back to unity of Allah. So while in some countries this situation of the people of cave puts us to anxiety, but on the other side, the verse Kataballahu laghlibanna ana wa rusuli, Allah Almighty has made it a decree that His messengers, Allah and His messengers, are going to become victorious. That gives us the satisfaction. The Messiah of Moses, after the period of their people of the cave, the spread of Christianity that was there, that resulted in the expansion of shirk, setting up partners with Allah Almighty. But the servants of the Messiah of Muhammad, before 300 years, inshallah, they are going to get the victory and dominance. And inshallah, they will be able to uproot the association of partners with Allah, and they will be able to establish the unity of Allah, the Tawheed. So we are never, we are least disappointed. And today in the world of Ahmadiyyat, a great expansion has taken place. Great advancement is there. If in some countries, limited countries, the Muslim are the rights of the Ahmadis and their freedom has been usurped, Australia, America, and in the islands, the people are enjoying the free life. I mean, the life of freedom. And for them to act upon the true teaching of Islam and Ahmadiyyat is and to impose those things on their life, the ways are all open, and the ways, paths of tabligh are also open. So I say to the Ahmadis living in these countries that this facility and freedom and the means which are available, use them for the achievement of your objective, and make them the source, means of achieving those objectives which have been set for you. And Allah Almighty saying, وَزِدْنَاهُمْ هُدَىٰ. They have not been mentioned only about for the people of the cave, but Allah Almighty has mentioned a principle that whosoever is going to protect his faith and he tries to be firmly established in religion, Allah Almighty is going to increase him in a guidance and also increase them in their faith. And this is what Allah Almighty has mentioned in Surah Al-Anfal as well. Allah Almighty says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا طُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. That believers are only those that when Allah Almighty is mentioned, then their hearts are filled with awe. And when the verses of the signs are repeated, that increases them in their faith. And they depend entirely upon Allah Almighty. And Allah Almighty says that these allazeena yuqeemuna salata, these are the people who establish the institution of prayer. And out of that which we have given them, they spend out of that. And Allah Almighty says, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقَّ لَهُمْ دَرَجَاتٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَمَغْفِرَةٌ وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ. That these are the true, real Muslims, believers, and they have got great ranks with Allah Almighty, and also for forgiveness, and also honorable provision is going to be provided to them. Allah Almighty has mentioned here the mention of a true Ahmadis, and the criteria and the characteristics of a true believer is mentioned. Those who claim to have faith, they don't become true believers just by their claim. There are some characteristics of that, some indications of that. And in times of trials, they protect their faith, and in their period of affluence, they also take care of their religious condition, and they become the recipient of the promises, such promises which Allah Almighty has given, which Allah Almighty has made to the true believers. If they have the claim, if somebody claims that he has firm faith in Allah, then each and every action and statement of that person should be for the sake of Allah. And the name of Allah should not be in his mouth or on his tongue. It should not be only that. Rather, and there should be awe of Allah in the hearts. The fear of Allah Almighty should be the heart. The indication of the faith is that when Allah Almighty is mentioned, then their hearts become full of fear, and they are terrified, because he is Allah Almighty is the most beloved being for a true believer, and his love should always be in the heart of a believer. But how you can get the pleasure of Allah Almighty? That is by acting upon his commandments. So this iman is not a simple lip service or a claim by your tongue, but one should be. And then, and Allah Almighty has also mentioned that the signs of Allah Almighty, they increase him in his faith. And these, there should be no excuses that these things are very difficult, that I can do that or I can't do that or it is impossible for me. But all the commandments of Allah Almighty, to listen to all those and to act upon them, to listen to them, this is actually the indication of the Muslim. Allah Almighty has also mentioned, وَإِذَا ذُكِرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ لَمْ يَخِرُوا عَلَيْهَا سُمَّمْ وَمْيَانَا, that when the verses of Allah Almighty are recited to them, so they don't treat it as the case of those who is deaf and blind. So simply the claim by tongue that I believe in unity of Allah Almighty, this does not become the means of increase in your faith until there is an effort to comply and to follow the commandments of Allah Almighty. So the effort to establish the unity of Allah Almighty will be successful when it is for the sake of Allah Almighty, and for the sake of Allah Almighty one is ready to offer oneself, and when in every matter completely dependence upon Allah Almighty is there. And then Allah Almighty says, then another indication of a true believer is the establishment of the prayer, ikamat salat. Now in the gatherings, in these ijtimaat, and after that, every khadim and every Ahmadi, as a matter of fact, they should be particularly establishing it, and they should make sure about that. During the ijtimaat, the prayer in congregation should be held, and afterwards as well, congregational prayer, it is very essential to continue with that even after the ijtimaat. And similarly, the people on duty, there are certain khudam who are on duty in among those who attend the ijtima, they should also take care of this and offer the prayers, and on the excuse of duty they should not deprive themselves from prayer. And it should not only be in the days of ijtima, as I said, in ordinary days as well. When our progress and our victory is linked with our worship, for which Hazrat Masih Maud has repeatedly reminded us, so then the best way of prayer, that is the Qiyam-e-Namaz, the establishment of institution of prayer, it is most needed that we should pay attention to that one. A Muslim, for the establishment of unity of Allah Almighty, and to believe only Allah Almighty to be the worthy of worship, this is the purpose of a Muslim. And to consider that this establishment of unity, and to consider him the worthy of worship, this can be done without establishing the institution of prayer. It is impossible. It cannot be without that. These five daily prayers are there, which are the means of breaking the idols in the hearts of a mu'min. And particularly in this materialistic world, these five daily prayers are there, which are the means of establishment of unity of Allah Almighty. And it breaks the idols within us, and also the idols of our other outward worldly means. So in order to establish the unity of Allah Almighty and to spread it, this is a basic recipe that we have to follow and always remember that. And then Allah Almighty says, وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ, that whatever we have given them, out of that they spend. For the propagation of religion, for the establishment of unity of Allah Almighty, and for those people who do, Allah Almighty increases them in their faith. So financial sacrifices, when these appeals are made in the Jamaat, that is also under this instruction of Allah Almighty. And the last verse which I have recited, in that Allah Almighty says, that the characteristics mentioned in the two previous verses, the one who is having those qualities, only those people are the true believers. And those who are true believers in the sight of Allah Almighty, they are the people. They are the who become the recipient of the blessings and the bounties of Allah. And what are those rewards? What are those blessings? لَهُمْ دَرَجَاتٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. With Allah, Almighty has got very high and lofty ranks for them. وَمَغْفِرَةٌ and forgiveness of their sins. وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ and also very honorable provision is for them. This is the provision of this life and the provision of the hereafter. So therefore the increase in faith and increase in guidance, it enables a person to inherit the blessings of Allah Almighty. And this is the duty of a mu'min and a believer, that in order to have the increase in that and in order to get the pleasure of Allah Almighty, one should keep himself busy all the time. And this is the true taqwa, which a person who wants to get the blessings of Allah Almighty gets all these things. And you move towards Allah Almighty. And by doing so, you increase in your righteousness. Allah Almighty says in one place, وَالَّذِينَ اَحْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ هُدَمْ وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ. And those people who got the guidance, and then it increased them in their guidance and gave them their taqwa, their righteousness. Ataahum takwahum. That Allah Almighty gave them their taqwa, their righteousness. That is to say, with the increase of the status of their player of the Allah Almighty, the taqwa also increases. And Allah Almighty gives to those people who advance towards Allah Almighty, and they are always seeking His pleasure and they are working hard for that. Allah Almighty shows them new and new ways. More and more ways are laid open. And as a result of that, their standard of righteousness also goes on increasing. And also, the fact that Allah Almighty wraps them in His sheet of His grace and mercy, He continues to envelop these people in that sheet, and they become more recipient of His blessings than ever before. And in the sight of Allah, they are always there. And their sacrifices in the presence of Allah Almighty, they are accepted. And the attempts of the enemies to terrify them, to terrify the believers, instead of terrifying them, that actually results in their getting nearness to Allah Almighty. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. Then that we are with you in this life and in the hereafter as well, we are with you. The faith in that continues to increase. And this faith in Allah Almighty was the thing which prompted the followers of the Messiah of Musa alayhi salam. And with us, the promises are much greater than them. So there is no reason that we should becoming disloyal to God Almighty. Or we should do it, or even think of that, doing that. And we should never ever be unmindful of His statements. For the establishment of unity of Allah Almighty, we should be unmindful of that. We cannot afford that. And as I said, in Pakistan and some other countries, those people who are the followers of Messiah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and a group of such people with steadfastness and patience, they are seeking steadfastness and patience and guidance. They are seeking for that and praying for that from Allah Almighty, and by the grace of Allah, in their faith, in their conviction, and in their guidance, they are also increasing. Allah Almighty is listening to the prayers of this group of people, and the strength of their faith and the ability to combat the satanic instigations, that is also the proof of the fact that Allah Almighty has accepted their prayers, and after listening to their prayers, their hearts have been strengthened. Among the youth, those people who are just entering into this age group of youth, and also the youth of mature age, all these khuddam, all these young people, with great conviction, without any fear. They are, whatever duties are allocated to them in Pakistan, they are performing those duties. Some senior members, they write to me that we are surprised to see the feelings and the passions of these young people. The Ahmadiyya mosques in Pakistan nowadays, particularly the Ahmadiyya mosques, Hazur says, they have been declared as very sensitive places by our administration, but the young people, they go there. And the people who write to me, some people write to me that if somebody is unable to go somewhere because of the duty, that it doesn't mean that the young people are less. There are more people who are ready to go there. And they are always trying that if some substitute is to be taken, then we are ready to take the, offer those services. And they, when they come back, then they say that, well, Alhamdulillah, we have come back safely, and if they, we don't come back, then Allah Almighty fulfill His promises in our favor. This is the faith which is being instilled in their hearts. It's a great zeal and passion which is there, which is being shown by these servants of the Messiah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah Almighty may and live and perpetuate these feelings and passions and also protect them, these people. Today, the believers of the Messiah of Muhammad, they are writing a unique history today. And these are those youth who are fulfilling their covenants and promises. And for the establishment of unity, they are not lagging behind from anybody else. These are actually those people who are actually offering their life and honor and their wealth, and they are always ready to offer these sacrifices. And certainly these are the people, they are going to get the extreme pleasure of Allah Almighty. So, following the path of righteousness and raising the standard of your worship, and try to get the pleasure of Allah Almighty more than ever before. Here, these people who are sitting in front of me are in Ijtimaga. Today is Khudam Al-Ahmadiyya's Ijtima, those who are sitting, and they are whom I am addressing directly. Those who, by the grace of Allah, those who have got the freedom of holding such gatherings, and as they like, whatever program they want to plan, they can act upon them. This is the freedom they enjoy. Those who have got the tarbiyat to make the tarbiyati programs, and those who have the freedom to formulate their tabligh programs, you should consider your responsibilities. You don't have to bring about a temporary change during the, these 3 days of Ijtima, but try to instill a permanent change in you. Raise the standards of taqwa, righteousness, and raise the high status of your worship. The standards of your worship. This vulgar attraction of the West should not be tempting you or attracting you in that way, or making you indifferent. And always keep in your mind the sacrifices of those brothers who are strengthening their faith, those who are raising high the standard of Ahmadiyya, the true Islam. They are doing everything for that purpose. They are through their loyalties, and by fulfilling their through their they are offering every type of sacrifice in order to fulfill their covenants. So as a great token of gratitude of this freedom, you have to do, you have to raise the standard of your worship and your sacrifices. And similarly, you should also try level best to spread the message of Ahmadiyya, and try to use each and every method of tabligh. There are modern ways and modern techniques are there, and the youth can use them more effectively. Now the Ahmadi youth, they have to play their role in two different fronts. The outer front, one is the reformation of the soul, is the inner front. And apart from that, the outside and the outer front are also two type. One is against Islam, they should take part in defense of Islam, and they have to defend Islam. And secondly, the attacks which are being made against Ahmadiyya, they also have to defend those attacks. Websites are there, and very vulgar criticisms or objections are raised. in them, you fill them with the message of truth. There should be an organized plan that in all these websites they are filled with the message of the truth that you have. If knowledge is deficient, then you get the help from the elders, from your missionaries. And now each and every khadam living in the world today, they should try to become a part of this campaign and scheme. Then you will be able to establish the unity of Allah and play the required role in that. The youth of the Messiah of Moses, they used to play their role in limited circles. But the servants of the Messiah of Muhammad, because of the new inventions and new means, you can bring about a big change in the whole world. So pay very special attention to this one. Allah Almighty enable all of them to do so. At the end, I would like to present one quotation from the writing of the Promised Messiah, Salatu Wasalam. He says, O my member of my community, Allah Almighty be with you all the time. Allah the Almighty, Allah Almighty prepare you for your journey of the hereafter as the companions of the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they were prepared. Remember it fully, that this world is nothing. This is full of curse, that life which is spent for the world. And very unfortunate is that who has got all the concern for the benefit of this world. Such a person, if such a person is a member of my community, then it is a futile, without any purpose he enters himself into my community. He is like a dry branch which is not going to bear any fruit. Oh fortunate ones, you enter into this community with full force and follow that guidance which I have been given for your guidance. And believe Allah Almighty, worthy of worship, without setting up any partners in the heaven or the earth. Allah Almighty does not stop you from using the worldly means, but the person who leaves Allah Almighty and entirely depends on the means, he is a mushrik, setting up partners with Allah Almighty. And in order to have the pure hearts, without becoming the pure hearts, there is no way of salvation. So have your hearts completely pure, and all these rancors and enmities, they should be thrown away. And there is always a tempting instigation is there, and there are weaknesses. If there was no arrogance, nobody would have been a disbeliever. So become very humble and modest, and be kind to the poor people as you advise them to go to the paradise. So this advice can only be true if you are also thinking ill of those people. All the requirements should be done with the hearts filled with fear, and to pray too much in your prayers, so that Allah Almighty could attract you to yourself and purify your hearts. Because a human being is very weak. Every weakness that is removed, that is removed with the help of Allah Almighty. And unless a person gets the help from Allah Almighty, no one is able to do so. Islam is not only this much, that just as a ceremony, you declare yourself those who pronounce kalima. But the truth, the reality of kalima is that your souls should be at the threshold of Allah Almighty. And these things, they become preferred by you at every point. And Allah Almighty enable us to act upon all these instructions given by the Promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam.
Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu. ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله
عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل واللسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر.